Hi guys, good evening. Hope you all are doing well. I'm super excited to be on this countdown series. I hope you all have already checked out the 10 things that you need to do in the 10 days so that you crack the cat, right? Let's crack it. So now we are going to look at the 9 major concepts in arithmetic that will really help you do well in the con section, right? Why arithmetic first? Because arithmetic is the most tested section in the CAT, right? So what are we waiting for? Hi, I'm Munira Lokhandwala and I'm Calcutta alumna, a serial 100 percentiler in the CAT and a 99 percentiler in the GMAT. I also have a CAT verbal book published by Wiley and available on Amazon, guys. You can see me on the Unacademy YouTube Crack CAT channel. I'm also taking a lot of sessions on the Unacademy app, right? So Unacademy app ke liye Google Play Store jaiye, search for it, download, install it. Within that, guys, you have to go for plus CAT courses, right? And besides these countdown series that I'm doing on the YouTube, I'm also doing a reviser series on the plus course in Unacademy. So the reviser series is a very interesting thing. You have 4 sections: arithmetic, algebra, geometry, and numbers. We are taking up each of them on one day. We're going through the important formulas, right? And then we are doing some questions to, you know, put the cement in the foundation, right? Make it strong. So that we are doing from next week, every day, Monday to Thursday at 9 o'clock in the morning. I'll be there with you to take you through the con section, right? Besides that, guys, another great reason you should be on the Unacademy platform is the variety, diversity that we have in our educators. We have close to 200 educators in just CAT, and they are, you know, consisting of people right from Himachal to Chennai. So we have, you know, people from every state. And we teach in all languages, right? So if language is a barrier in Unacademy, there is no such barrier, right? So great. Another reason why you should be on Unacademy ASAP is the National Scholarship Test. These are a series of tests that we have been running from 18th of October. This Sunday, 22nd November, is our last test, and you're going to be tested on the verbal section, right? So I want you to take the test. Every Sunday hota hai 5 baje, 5 to 5:40, 40 minute mein. Agar aap top 50 mein aate ho, so you get 5,000 rupees. That is such great return for money, I can't even tell you, right? It should be a part of our maths question, that what is the kind of return you can expect if in 40 minutes you make 5,000 rupees, right? And this is an open test, so students from all across the country take this regularly. And you get great analysis, well-designed test, right? There's not a single negative thing. You must take this test, enroll and take it this Sunday, right? Already 250 students have got vouchers. I don't want you all to miss out. Also, I'm taking the plus batch on LRDI every Monday to Friday at 7:30. I'll be taking all these interesting, lovely sets on logical reasoning and data interpretation. So I hope to see you there as well, guys. Which subscription to go for? That we can talk towards the end of the session. Do use my code Munira10 to get a great discount, right? So chaliye kood padte hain into arithmetic concepts that are important. So 2 concepts we are going to do with respect to work. One is working with work as ratios, which is this one, and the next one is working with work as units. Okay. So ye ratios ka matlab kya hai? Kab use karna hai? So there are 2 kinds of questions that you see in work. Ek mein, you know, there are groups of people, and within a group, people have the same efficiency. Okay. And dusra question hota hai, where everyone is working individually or sabke alag alag efficiency hota hai. To ye wale question hum karenge units ke saath, aur ye wala question hum karenge ratios ke saath. As much as possible, in fact, all the time, I avoid fractions. I don't like fractions. I don't like equations. So how can we do such questions without fractions also and equations also? So here is a CAT 2018 question. Let's solve it. Human and robots can both perform a job but at different efficiencies. So ye hai dekho. All humans are the same efficiency. All robots are the same efficiency. But humans and robots within themselves have different efficiencies. So you have 15 humans and 5 robots. And they take 30 days to do something. And then you have 5 humans and 15 robots. And they take 60 days to do something. Why are they taking 60 days? Because their efficiency is half. क्योंकि थोड़ी स्लो है तो उसको हम 30 डेज में कन्वर्ट करने के लिए लेट्स डबल द पीपल. जो 5 ह्यूमंस है उसको 10 ह्यूमंस कर देते हैं, जो 15 रोबोट्स है उसको 30 रोबोट्स कर देते हैं. सो नाउ द वर्क दैट 15 ह्यूमंस एंड 5 रोबोट्स डू इन अ डे इज डन बाय 10 ह्यूमंस एंड 30 रोबोट्स. And now we will find the ratio. So, 5 humans ka kaam jo hai, wo 25 robots karte hain. So, if a robot is doing 1 unit a day, a human is doing 5 units a day. So, this is the ratio. Yahan se hame pata chalta hai ki human and robots ka kya interaction hai. Right? So, robot ka 1 unit and humans then are doing 5 times the work a robot is doing. So, if you are... This is your work, right? 30 days mein kaam ho raha hai with 15 humans. That's 75 units of work. Each human is 5 units. And 5 robots is 5 units. So, 80 units in a day and 30 days. So, aapka kaam pura 80 into 30. Right? Now, 15 humans working together without any robot. 15 humans are going to do 75 units of work. Right, so if I just do some cancellations, this is 16 here and this is 25, right? And you have, not 25, sorry, 15, and you have a 2 here, so answer is 32. Okay, so this is the way you solve ratios related questions. Now, how about when people are working with different efficiencies. Say pipe ka question hai, par ye bhi work ka hi question hai. Right? Very easy question. Outlet pipe is closed, inlet pipe takes 8 hours and with open it takes 10 hours. So, aise questions mein hamesha you find an LCM of all the numbers. So, 8 or 10 ka LCM hai 40. Let 40 liters be the capacity of your tank. तो इनलेट पाइप इज फिलिंग इन 5 लीटर्स पर आवर, इसलिए वो 8 घंटे में उसने भर दिया 40 डिवाइडेड बाय 8. विद द आउटलेट इट इज टेकिंग 4, यू नो इट्स फिलिंग 4 लीटर्स पर आवर. सो व्हाई इज इट फिलिंग 4 लीटर्स विद द आउटलेट? क्योंकि 1 लीटर लीक हो रहा है. ओके, सो द आउटलेट पाइप इज लीकिंग 1 लीटर आउट पर आवर. So, if only the outlet pipe is open, then the full tank becomes half full. Matlab, jo 40 liter ko mujhe 20 liter karna hai, uske liye I will take 20 hours. Right? So, answer is option A, 20 hours. Third question, time, speed, distance ka inverse. Inverse ratio is so important in the CAT, right? It comes in time, speed, distance, it comes in mixtures, allegations, it can come in interest questions. Agar do logo ka interest equal hai, right? Then, agar interest rate is in the ratio 2:3, the principal will be in the ratio 3:2, correct? So, inverse ratio aata hi hai when products are equal. So, in these cases, right, what is equal is the distance is equal. Every day, this man is going the same distance. What is distance? Speed into time. So, the product of speed and time is equal. So, jab wo 12 kilometer ki speed pe jata hai, right? To 10 minutes late hai. Agar wo 15 kilometer ki speed pe jayega, so now speed is increasing in the ratio 4:5. So, time should go down in the ratio 5:4. Agar wo 10 minute pehle late tha, aur abhi 10 minute early hai, correct? So, the gap between 5 and 4 is 20 minutes. And the original gap, correct? The original gap between, the original, sorry, time is 100 minutes. 5 into 20. This gap of 1 corresponds to 20 minutes. So, 5 corresponds to 100 minutes. So, jo ye 100 minutes hai, it is 5/3 of an hour. And the speed is 12. So, the distance is going to be 20. Correct? So, 20 kilometers is the distance. Great, guys. Next concept is the successive increase decrease concept. So what is the successive increase decrease concept? That if I increase one quantity, right? Like, let's say I have a cost price of 2000. So I increase it by 10%, correct? To get a marked price of 2200. Then I decrease it by 5% to get the selling price, correct? So one way of doing this is now to multiply with 0.95, right? Or you can find out 1 by 20 of this is 1 by 20 is basically 2200 ka 1 by 20, right, is 110. So you subtract 110 from here and you land up with 2090 is the price. So ek way ye hai. The other is to say ki overall the change is going to be plus 10 minus 5 plus 10 into minus 5 divided by 100. So this is your A plus B plus AB by 100 formula. Whenever I'm successively increasing or decreasing or a combination, bas aap minus barabar se bhari ho, I can use this formula. So ye kya ho gaya? Ye hai 5 minus 0.5. So overall 4.5 ka change hai. So you see, this is maybe a little faster depending on the numbers, right? Finding 0.95 of 2200 may be more tedious. It may be easier to find 4.5 of 2000, ki haan, ye toh 90 hai, and find out ki yes, the answer is going to be 2090. So this is your successive increase decrease funda, right? Now let's do our question. In a village, the production of food grains increased by 40%, right? So jo food grains hai, production, I can see this as number of people kitne hai aur per capita un log kitna khate hai. That will give me total food. So ye hai increase hua 40% se. Jabki per capita increase hua hai 27% se. So is pe kitna increase hua hai? So you say, right, you can say 40 is equal to A plus B plus AB by 100. Where this is 27, right? So 13 se thoda kam milega aapko answer. So 10 is best, right? So successive increase decrease ke saath, this becomes a very quick question to do. If in fact you have to do 1.4 over 1.27, this may look a little tedious, right? Great. Next question. Now we have the concept of equating ratios. So whenever you have two different ratios, two different quantities, always try equate it first, equate a quantity, and then find the multiplier. Equate and find the multiplier. So let's see that in action here, correct? C1, C2, C3 are in this ratio. C2, C4, C5 are in this ratio. So C2 common hai, usko hume same karna hai. So yahan pe 10 hai, yahan pe 18 hai. So iska HCF, right, 10 and 18 ka is 90. Multiply this with 9, so you get 81, 90 and 72, and multiply this, right, with 5 and you get 90, 95 and 100. So equate ho gaya, sub ho gaya, now you have to find the multiplier. C5 has made a profit of 19 crores more. Yahan pe C5 has made a profit of 19 more. So 19 corresponds to 19 crores. So multiplier is 1 crore. So all 5 ka hume sum karna hai. Right? And then multiply it with 1 crore. So answer is going to be 438 crore. You add all of these up. Correct? You can start with these 3. This is 285. Right, and then you are going to add 153 to that, so answer is going to be 438. Next concept. For averages, don't always work with equations, right? Sometimes you can just work with differences. So class consists of 20 boys and 30 girls. Right, the average score of the girls was 5 higher than that of the boys. Final exam, average score of the girls dropped by 3. That means overall the sum should have dropped by 60. So I'm even ignoring A, B, I ignore them. Forget this. Average score of the girls dropped by 3. So total must have dropped by 60. But average score of the whole class, not 60, sorry, 90. Whole class, right? 30 into 3. Went up by 2. So actually overall there's a plus 100. So the difference of 190 is coming because of the 20 boys, and hence boys' ka average must have increased by 9.5. So you see, hardly anything to write, hardly anything to solve. It becomes very easy if you work with differences. Ki kya farak kya pada isse, instead of working with the full numbers, right? Next concept, choose substitution over equations. Don't start with x. See whether you can easily substitute, and always start with the easiest substitution. So Arun drove home from home to his hostel at 60. While returning home, he drove half at 25, and then he took a bypass where he could drive at 50. Return journey took 30 minutes more. Abhi instead of doing right kx by 60 plus 30 minutes, which is half an hour, right, is equal to... Just look at how I just get so bored when I do all this, right? Adha rasta at 25 and adha rasta plus 5. The whole by 50. Kitta, just, it's ugly. Instead, I know ke 60 miles hai, so I want to start with a multiple of 3, so life will be easier. I don't want to start with 55 miles. Isko to adha karenge to problem ho jayega. Correct? So I want to start with 60 miles, and then of course aate waqt to 5 miles bada raha hai, so actually I'm in fact starting with 65 miles. So jaate waqt uska distance hai 30, correct? 30 hai, jo wo aadhe ghante mein khatam kar leta hai, right? Aate waqt then, jo 30 ka aadha 15, he's traveling at 25, that should take him 3/5 of an hour. And the remaining 15 पे वो 5 ऐड करके वो 50 पे कवर कर रहा है 2/5 ऑफ एन आवर, तो वो एक घंटे में कवर कर रहा है, तो एक घंटा आधा घंटा उसको ज्यादा लग रहा है. इट्स सो इजी, राइट? जस्ट टू सब्स्टिट्यूट. सो एट टाइम्स व्हेन द आंसर इज देयर इन योर ऑप्शंस, चूज सब्स्टिट्यूशन ओवर इक्वेशंस, राइट? मिक्सचर्स ऑल्सो डू नॉट यूज इक्वेशंस, ट्राई एंड सी व्हेदर यू कैन वर्क विदाउट इट. So 20% ethanol is mixed with another ethanol of unknown concentration in the proportion 1:3. This is then mixed with an equal volume of 20% ethanol. Okay, the resultant mixture is a 31.25 ethanol solution. I have to find unknown the concentration. So pehle to, you know, you have concentration X that you are mixing with 20% or wo equal hai. ये अगर एक है तो ये भी एक है, एंड राइट, ये 31.25 हो गया. तो यहाँ पे 11.25 का गैप है, तो यहाँ पे भी 11.25 का गैप होगा, बिकॉज द रेशियो ऑफ मिक्सिंग इज इक्वल. सो दिस मस्ट बी 42.5. सो नाउ वी कम बैक टू दिस स्टोरी दैट आई एम मिक्सिंग अ 20% इथेनॉल सॉल्यूशन. Right, with another solution, again X, so that after mixing we land up at 42.5. ये mixing है 1:3 में, so this will be in the ratio 3:1. ये distance है 22.5, correct? Divide by 3, 7.5. So ये distance at 7.5 and we land up with 50%. So answer is the second option, 50%. Right? Great, guys. Last concept, translate questions. अभी ये देखो, arithmetic का question है, पर उसमें algebra भी है. Correct? Population of a town, 3+2p. I hope you can see, यहाँ पे compound interest is used. So you say, forget all this. ये देखो, 2019. Right? So let me just again read the question for you. Population of a town is p. At the end of the year, it becomes 3 plus 2p. 2019 mein wo 1000 hai. Then the population, the beginning of 2034 will be what? Okay. So, 15 years pass hote hain 2019 se 2034 aur har ek option mein 15 hai. तो अगर मैं 2019 को 2020 करती हूँ तो कितना होता है पॉपुलेशन 1000 बिकम्स 2003 डबल प्लस 3 सो इंस्टेड ऑफ 15 इफ आई सब्स्टिट्यूट वन ईयर आई शुड गेट राइट दिस इज अ जनरल फॉर्मूला सो इफ आई सब्स्टिट्यूट वन ईयर ईयर आई गेट 1009 दिस इज नॉट योर आंसर राइट आई एम सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग 15 के बजाय पुटिंग 1 यहाँ पे इफ आई गेट पुट वन आई गेट 974 नॉट एन आंसर यहाँ पे आई पुट वन आई गेट 2006 माइनस 3 परफेक्ट लवली आई गेट दिस यहाँ पे आई पुट 0 आई नीड टू पुट राइट देन आई गेट 977 प्लस 3 1000 दिस आल्सो डजंट वर्क सो आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी इनफैक्ट यू डोंट इवन नीड टू गो टू 2000 You can say के अरे 2019 year zero, year is zero, first year, right? शुरू भी नहीं हुआ है. Answer is 1000. So if I put, instead of 15, if I put 0, I should get 1000 as an answer. यहाँ पे आता है 6, यहाँ पे आता है minus 2, correct? This is 1 plus 6, sorry, not 6, sorry, I get 7. This is 1 minus 3, so it's minus 2. But here I get 1003 minus 3, I get 1000. So C in both cases is your answer, right? So great guys, I'll see you again when we do the 8 tests that you need to take on an academy, right? To bolster your preparation. I know what I have told you. When I spoke about 10 things to do, I said that we need to just take 4 tests. So the reason I'm giving 8 tests is that you can choose which one of these to take. You may have taken some of them already. Right? So let's see which are the 8 interesting tests that you can take on an academy in the next session, guys. As usual, please enroll for an academy because of the national scholarship test. So ye jo last ka test hai ye Sunday ko, do ensure that you take it up, right? We have a great environment. I've spoken about this various times. But right now, because of your CAT, the first thing that I want to thrust, right, is the national scholarship test. So do take enroll for the Unacademy National Scholarship Test, right? Which subscription to go for? Well, if you're a CAT 20 student, then I would say ki 3 mahine ka ya 6 mahine ka le lo. I would really recommend the 6-month subscription because then we'll be with you till May and we can take care of GDPI, Written Assessment Test and other exams such as CMAT, XAT and everything else. If you're focused on CAT 2021, then you can look at the 2-year subscription, right? You can use my code MUNIRA10 to get a great discount. I'll see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.